In this video, we're going to update our Google Analytics property and our Webflow site to make sure we have Google's new Google Analytics 4 fully set up. So if you have a Webflow site and it's set up with the older Google Analytics, the Universal Analytics, and you're looking to migrate to the new GA4, this is the video for you. So we're gonna do this migration in 4 different stages. The first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna use the GA4 setup assistant, and that's gonna migrate from our existing Google Analytics property, the old one, to the new one. And we're gonna do all of that in Google Analytics. The second thing we're gonna do is we're gonna grab the new ID from Google Analytics. Third, we'll make that swap. We'll update our Webflow site so the updated ID is switched over seamlessly. And finally, fourth, we're gonna test to make sure all of this is successfully connected and our new GA4 ID is linked to our Webflow site. Okay, for the first part, we're gonna start where everyone starts by logging in to Google Analytics. And if it doesn't immediately come up, what we're looking for is the property we want to change. In this case, the property that's currently linked to our Webflow site. So we can see if we go up to this dropdown, we have our property we configured a long time ago, and we're going to click over and open it up. What we're looking for here is admin. And right there, right under our property, is the GA4 setup assistant, exactly what we're looking for. And what this does is it creates a new property, a Google Analytics 4 property, and it creates a connection to your old property. So what is this doing exactly? It's taking those top-level property settings, not the historical data that stays in your old property, but it's essentially creating a starting point so it can collect data in the new GA4 property. Keep in mind, Google controls how long that old property is going to keep that data, so check their updated documentation to make sure you export or you log any of that measurement data, any historical data that's at risk. And make sure to do that before any end dates that Google might set, so your info doesn't just evaporate. So back in our setup assistant, let's press get started. And before we continue, we're going to enable data collection using existing tags. This of course is entirely up to you, but what it essentially does is it brings over the connected tags that were previously set up in your old property. That way you don't have to manually set them up again in your new GA4 property. Google has some really great documentation here if you want to get in and learn more. But for now, we're going to hit create property. And just like that, we've created and we connected the new Google Analytics 4 property. Let's go over to that exact property. And here it is, our setup checklist for the new property. Now, there's a lot of stuff here that's optional, but we really do recommend taking a moment, taking the time to look through several of these checkpoints to see what might make sense. Keeping in mind, again, that most of these are optional. Our goal here is to focus on this one, the one about managing data streams. By the way, at any time, we can get back to this outside of this checklist, and we can do that from the left sidebar under data streams. Now, in this example, we're going to click web, and the reason is because you might have additional streams for iOS or Android, and we wanna make sure we're opening up the web data stream for this property. So once we do, let's click on the data stream, and we can move into the second step because this step is all about copying the measurement ID. So how do we do that? We click to copy the measurement ID. That's 2 steps down, and the third is almost as easy as the second. So we're in our Webflow site, the one that's linked to this property. And in order to make the swap, we want to go into our site settings. Let's go over to the integrations tab where we can see Google Analytics. A couple things to do here. First, let's use this to remove the existing tracking from the old Google Analytics. And then second, we want to paste in that measurement ID, the thing we just copied to our clipboard in the last step. So when we do that, let's save our changes. And at this moment, remember, right now, our existing site, the published site, still has the old Google Analytics info. So once we publish from here, it'll swap out everything with our new ID, our new Google Analytics 4 measurement ID. Okay, final step, let's test this. If we open up Google Analytics and we go to view our actual analytics data, we view the info on this property. By the way, remember, check to make sure this is your new GA4 property that we just created. So if you have bookmarks or links to your old Google Analytics stuff, make sure to update that with the new property. So once we validated this is the right property, we can go over, if we're not there already, to home. And let's take a look at some of this real-time data. Now, we know with any third-party tracking, it's not 100% accurate. Sometimes there's tracking blockers, customer and user permissions, but we can always test this out on any device, or we can ask a friend or a colleague to do the same. And as long as this kind of tracking isn't blocked on that person's device, they should show up pretty quickly in the real-time info. If this isn't happening, or you see something about the data stream not being connected, it's really helpful to ensure that the measurement ID was pasted over correctly from the new GA4 property, and of course, that your site has been fully published. If, for whatever reason, the data's still not showing, Google has an entire area of support called Analytics Help, which has help topics and even a community where folks can talk through more specific problems and get the help they need. And if at any time you want to view or you want to reference your historical data, that data that was collected in your old property, you can access that old property in the dropdown and you can view that data and even export that data so you can save it. However, remember to check Google's documentation so you know when your old property and all of that related data will no longer be available. So, let's quickly recap what we did. First, we migrated our existing Google Analytics property to the new one, the GA4 one. We copied the new ID from Google Analytics. We made the switch in Webflow, so our Webflow site is using the updated ID. And finally, we tested to make sure everything connected properly. Now, we have plenty of up-to-date documentation that can help in this process and really connect you to the answers that you need regarding GA4, the migration process. So check that out on Webflow University if you haven't already. And as a reminder, as we said just a moment ago, Google Analytics Help is really great for GA4 specific questions and answers. But that's migrating your old Google Analytics property to Google's new Google Analytics 4 property in Webflow.